Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. For today's video, I'm going to be doing a little life update because I do have some things going on in the background, as you can tell from the title, and I'm not going to really be talking too much about the products that I'm using, but I will put overlays on the screen so that you can see what I'm using. But the main focus as far as products, what I'm testing out today, mostly is the ColourPop and Barbie collection. I know this came out a while ago. I never really got around to trying it out, so that's what I'm gonna try out today. But nonetheless, we're just getting ready, chit-chatting, life update, all of that good stuff. Let's get into it. Me pull my hair back. I believe I got this headband from Forever 21 a while back. Kind of makes my head hurt, but whatever. Okay, so I'm gonna start off by priming. I've been really enjoying the Milani SPF BFF. It just makes me feel superior. Like I'm getting in an extra layer of SPF. It's not my favorite feeling on the skin. Okay, I'm avoiding talking about myself. If you don't know, guys, I'm not the best person about talking about myself, and I have this thing where I feel like nobody cares. But big announcement, as you can tell from the title, I have decided, I have decided to leave teaching. So I just finished up the school year this Friday, and today is actually Monday. So it's technically like my first day of creating content full time, which is really exciting for me. I'm mixing this Sephora Best Skin Ever and the Dior Forever Skin Glow because this is too dark and this is way too light for me. I know a lot of you guys saw this coming. I haven't given hints or anything, but I've definitely received DMs where you guys knew I wasn't going to come back and that this was my last year teaching. And I just want to say, I'm not going to talk crap about the education system or how much I hate teaching, because that's not the truth. Is teaching a perfect profession? No, there's a lot of things in the system that are messed up, but I'm not quitting teaching because I disliked it. This year was so chaotic. It was horrible. But because of it, I'm able to do what I am doing now. So I am very lucky to say that I am sad to be leaving teaching. I will miss it. It was a really tough decision for me to decide to leave teaching. I hemmed and hawed. I went back and forth, you know. My administration was genuinely sad to see me go. I was sad to go, but ultimately I had to make the decision that was best for me. And if I'm being completely honest with myself, teaching was great. I really enjoyed teaching. I had wanted to be a teacher my entire life growing up. I had never seen this as my future. This doing YouTube and content creation, getting to review makeup products was an untouchable dream for me. I always thought, how amazing would it be to be able to just play with makeup as a job? And then I created my channel with zero intentions of ever going full time. And I didn't even think that would ever happen until a little less than a year ago. You know, ultimately, I was always content and happy with the idea of teaching being my career. But over time, you know, in my wildest dreams, I had thought about YouTube being a full-time career, but it was never my goal because that was just so untouchable to me. I didn't think I would ever get to that point. And over the time and over the years that I have done this, I mean, YouTube was my true passion. It was my true hobby. You know, I always saw teaching as my career and I was content doing it. I liked it. But there's a difference between what you're content doing and what your passion is. And I am so humbled by the fact that it got to the point where my passion has become my career, because getting to the nitty-gritty, I know what you guys are curious about, the money, all of that. Time-wise, I was drowning, you guys. I was making enough money from YouTube to where it took a step up in my priorities. And of course, teaching, you know, I have other kids relying on me. Taught at a Title I school. So I was giving all of my time, 24 hours, to my job, to my passion. And then wedding season started in the last few months. And it was getting to a point where either teaching or YouTube was going to have to give. You know, I recently got married in August, if you didn't know, and I'll get into this later on in this video, but my husband is going through an immigration process. So he's not allowed to work right now. He sits at home all day. He doesn't know anybody. His family is not allowed to visit. He's not allowed to visit his family or leave the country, which that has lifted now. His family's coming to see us in August, which is exciting. But up until recently, recently because of COVID, his family couldn't even come down and he can't go right now. He can't leave the country because of our immigration process. So he's just sitting at home all day and I'm working every hour of the day that I'm awake. I was teaching all day until 4 p.m. coming home, filming and editing videos. And then on the weekends when the wedding started, I didn't have time to even spend time with my husband. I didn't have time for myself. Both outlets were making me money. Good money. You know, I would not be quitting teaching if YouTube wasn't able to sustain me. It's no secret. I mean, relatively speaking, teachers don't make the most money for the amount of professionalism that is required for us, our level of education, because pretty soon I was going to have to start getting credits for my master's degree, because in order for me to continue teaching and having my certification, I needed to go to grad school. Oh gosh. Like, adding that on top of it, it's just the amount of work that you do for teaching and the level of education, all of that. I mean, it's no secret. You don't get paid the most. So I was at the point financially where I was like, you know, there's not much room for growth in teaching. I think between my first and second year, I got a $600 raise. And just generally speaking, the way that my county works, there really isn't much room for growth. YouTube is different. Now, there's also room to go down, but there's also a lot more room to go up as well. And I really believe, you know, with having extra time, it's fine. And financially, though, I'm not taking a financial risk by quitting my job. I'm losing a salary, which completely sucks. But for me, that is made up for in the time I get to spend with my husband, in the time that I get to spend with my family, in the time that I have to myself, because I didn't have that before. So much of my energy was given for others, for teaching, you know, for getting reviews up early for you guys, getting people ready for their wedding days. It's exhausting. It really is. I loved it, but gosh, I was just tired. I needed time for myself. Back to the point, you know, YouTube is my passion. I've been given this opportunity where I am able to be able to do it full time, and that doesn't happen for a lot of people. A lot of people don't get to turn their passions into their career. I have a lot of goals that I need to do here, and I feel like I can now finally get started because I have the time to do it and the energy to do it. That was also a big part. Sometimes, you know, I wouldn't film when I would get home from school and I'd miss out on these opportunities because I was just tired. I didn't have the energy for it, and I feel like I can really capitalize on the energy that I have now. So when did I make the decision to go full-time? I want to say it was about probably in January, early this year, maybe a little bit earlier, because I started to see the possibility of it come into fruition probably in the summer of last year. So being 100% honest, I don't think if COVID had happened, this would be happening. Obviously, I don't wish COVID ever happened, but I was able to take full advantage of the time that I was given. In the beginning, my county was a mess. From March to June, I had a lot of free time. So I took that time to see what it would be like to go full-time with YouTube. Now, it wasn't full-time because I still, you know, had to teach a little bit. I still had grading to do, all of that. I still had some professional responsibilities. But I treated YouTube as my full-time job. And from those months, June all the way up until January, when I went back into work full-time in person, I had seen a lot of growth. My subscriber count doubled. The amount of money I was making more than doubled. And that was when I really started to see, oh, the numbers are lining up. I could do this full time. And so after seeing the numbers, seeing the growth, seeing the potential of me having a full time schedule on YouTube, I had decided around January that once the school year was going to end, that I wanted to make YouTube my full time job. Now, there are other factors besides, oh, I just love doing it, that made it make sense, which I'm about to get into. But yeah, I mean, this is my announcement. I have decided to go full time with YouTube, and my goals are to post at least 5 times a week, be more present, be in my DMs more, answering comments, interacting with you guys more, really building my community, and continue to do what I'm doing in the beauty industry, and, you know, hopefully make a difference, make my own place in the industry, have our own little community here. That's what I'm doing. That's kind of my mission. Expect a lot more content from me, and I finally have more time. The guilt I felt for like not being able to answer comments, I knew it wasn't that big of a deal to you guys. You knew what the situation was. I love this so much. I love the community that I built, and I felt like I couldn't even be a part of it because I was so focused on still just uploading, getting the content up for you guys, that I couldn't respond back to comments and all that. And so I feel so much peace and happiness knowing that I can finally be a part of my own community and continue to build it and grow it. So be on the lookout because I have some fun plans for my channel, and just I want to take everything up a notch for sure. I bought a new computer so that I can super edit. I have to learn a new editing software. I haven't sat down to learn it, but Jose is going to help me out right now while he's at home. So I'm really, really excited about that. So that's the biggest update. I am now full-time content creator. I feel so humbled and grateful for you guys because obviously I wouldn't be able to turn my passion into a career if it weren't for you guys. So thank you to each and every one of you who have ever taken the time to sit down and watch my videos, to comment, to like, to shop through my affiliate links, and just taking that extra step to support me. Like, you have ultimately changed my life and made my dreams come true, and it's only hopefully just the beginning. I'm so excited to see what the future brings and what I can give you guys. Thank you for what you have given me. And like I said, there's more reasons as to why I decided to leave my teaching position. And one of them is Jose and I have plans to move eventually. If you don't know my current living situation, my husband and I are living with my parents, which I haven't gotten very many rude comments about that, but I've gotten some, like a couple rude comments about that. I don't get what the big deal is. We have a good relationship with my parents, but most importantly, my husband's going through an immigration process and he's not allowed to work. That puts a lot of financial responsibility on me. We get along with my parents. We have a great relationship and there is literally no problems with us living together. Jose just meshes so well with my family, and especially while I was working, you know, he would have been at home alone knowing nobody if we were to move away. At least, you know, I felt better knowing he had my parents. You know, my mom works from home, so that situation worked out for us. And we are just waiting for immigration to give us a work visa so that we can stop mooching off my parents and move out. We do have plans on it. It's not on us. We are planning to move, hopefully, down to Florida. Jose's from Spain, and he essentially moved across the world for me, left his family behind. So we had a conversation a few months ago, and I said, you know, why don't you pick where you want to live, and we'll go there. If I'm doing YouTube full time, that gives me the flexibility to go wherever you want, to get whatever job that you want and that you would be happy doing. And so he's decided on Florida. Obviously, things could change depending on the job situation for him, because I really want him to get a job that he enjoys. He's allowing me and fully supporting me to have the job that I want, which is doing this. So I want that for him as well. So he has chosen Florida. We feel like they have a bigger Spanish culture down there, so he'd feel more comfortable, because he's not very happy where we're at right now. We don't have a mortgage. We don't have kids. If there's any time to kind of take a risk, and it's not even too much of a risk if I'm being honest, but if there was a time for us to discover a new place to live and find out what the best area for us is, it's now. So we are looking in and out of Florida, but again, we are waiting on that work visa, unfortunately, and that is what is halting us. So as soon as he gets that work visa and he gets a job, we're moving to wherever his job is. And I mean, that was also another reason why I left teaching, was knowing that I was moving and I did not want to commit to another school year. Teaching is very different. You know, you enter into a year-long contract. I did not want to start a new school year and then leave my kids. Teaching at a Title I school is different than teaching anywhere else. I want to be a level of consistency in their lives. So I just didn't want to change schools like that. I just didn't want to quit halfway through the year like that. And as far as Jose's immigration status, there isn't much of an update. I wish I had one, but I don't. If you've been through an immigration process before, you know what it's like. You're just waiting. There was a bit of a setback that we had where there was a big form that we didn't turn in. Got set back a couple of months because we basically had to start over. But right now, everything seems good. They've given us, you know, notice that everything's being processed. They haven't rejected anything yet. They haven't sent back our packet yet. We got another notice in the mail yesterday that they were continuing to process it. It said something else, but essentially what I interpreted as is like when he got his interview, he had to like go to the doctor and do a checkup or something. I don't know. Basically what it said to me was, we're still looking through your stuff. So to me, that was a win. So it could be any day now. Probably, I'm predicting, wishful thinking, by the end of summer he'll have it, but realistically it will probably be later. In the best world, we would be up and moving to Florida in September or October, and then we don't want to move in November or December because that's a big month for YouTube. As you know, it's the holiday season, so I want to post every day. I want to hit all of the new Christmas releases and holiday releases for you guys, and as well as YouTube AdSense pretty much doubles because advertisers are paying more to get their ads up on our videos. So I don't think we'll move in November, December. So if it doesn't happen in September, October, then we'll probably move in January if we have the work visa by them. But we're really excited, and if you know anything about Florida, I am all ears. I love hearing and learning since I haven't been there too often. I think that just based on my research, Tampa's my favorite place. We are going to Tampa in early July just to check it out for a little vacation. And then we also think he has a communications degree and he would love to get into a career that's like video editing, filming commercials, all of that. So we do think with what he wants to do, maybe Miami would be a better place where he's more likely to get a job. So we're also looking there. I'm gunning for Tampa, but again, we're gonna visit Miami as well in August with his family when they come to visit. And we'll kind of see, but the biggest determination of where we end up in Florida is wherever the man gets a job. Okay, side note about this palette. How cute is this? This is such a fun palette for summer. I'm definitely featuring this in my top summer palettes. And so far the quality has been decent. I've been very happy with it. It gets the job done for like simple looks, you know? Pop in a little bit of orange on here. I like that. I pulled the perfect blush. I'm using Cherish from Pat McGrath. I've been going ham on these blushes. They are amazing. It's gonna make the lid color pop more. So basically, I mean, those are the major life updates that I can give you guys. YouTube's now my full-time job. So excited about that. My dreams are coming true. Thank you. Jose's immigration status, we are just waiting and waiting and waiting until something happens. They don't really give you much warning either. We are on their time. Once Jose gets a job and his work visa, we are out of Maryland and we are most likely moving somewhere warmer like Florida. And that's what's up with me. Now that I have more time, I would love to hear what you would like to see more of on my channel. I'm using the Barbie highlight now, by the way. I want to expand my content. I'm gonna obviously make up. It's gonna be the majority of my channel, but I'm thinking about not every week. We'll see how it goes because I don't know how I can maintain this, but maybe once in a blue moon, every other week, maybe once a month, doing like a weekly vlog. I don't know. If I like it, maybe I'll post one every week. I don't like it, maybe I won't post one every week. But that way I feel like I can really incorporate a lot of more behind the scenes and of course my other interests, because I think being a teacher before, I really strayed away from posting to personal content like that because of my students. You know, it already was breaking a barrier I felt when my students knew I had a channel. My elementary students this year did not know I have a channel that I'm aware of, but I taught middle school the year before and they knew. And so I have always been very, very mindful of what I posted. And it was already a lot knowing that they knew about my channel. I had to make sure I kept everything very, very makeup related. And I feel like I don't need to do that as much more. And a lot of you guys have asked me questions about what other interests I have, what I'm up to behind the scenes. So I think I want to start doing like a once a week vlog. I'm still gonna be a makeup channel and don't worry about that. Let me pick the lip before I go into eyes. So I'm looking through the lip duos. This one's gorgeous. I might do this one. The packaging of these lip duos are so stunning. This one's a little bit warm. I think I might want to do actually this. No, I don't know. these lip duos, I don't know if they even still sell the Barbie collection, but if they do, I recommend it. These lip duos are awesome. They're so cute. Look at that hot pink. Okay, I'm gonna do the first lip duo, which is Dream House. I like keep losing my train of thought. So obviously I will be doing some behind the scenes makeup stuff that I'm wearing, hair, skin updates on there, unboxings, just like really behind the scenes stuff. But I also want to start incorporating like life, like healthy lifestyle stuff. Like I'm not the best example of like a fully healthy life, but I live a very balanced life. And guys, I was a PE teacher, a physical education teacher. I'm qualified to teach about this stuff. I would love to incorporate more about how I incorporate health in a balanced way. My exercise routine, not the best eater, but I don't know. Maybe I'll talk about that a little bit more now that I have to be more conscious because I'm not moving as much. And then as Jose and I's moving process evolves, put stuff like that on camera. Just those behind the scene things and other things that interest me, clothes, jewelry, all of that. I want you guys to also be a part of that if you're interested. So let me know how that sounds. This is cute. I love how it goes with the lip. I didn't do a crazy eye look today because I was just chit-chatting, but it's a cute look for fun. I have a friend coming over today. I'm gonna do her makeup. She has a wedding that she's attending and she has a deeper skin tone, and I've been looking to practice on more deeper skin tones. Like I have experience, you know, I've been trained, all of that, but a lot of the clientele that I've been having have had lighter skin tones, and I still want to keep myself well practiced and all of that. So I'm gonna do her makeup. I asked her to come over. Let me put on some eyeliner and mascara. I'm gonna do this off camera because I take forever to do it and I can't talk. Then I'll be back. Okay, so here is the final look. I used the doll lashes that came with the Barbie collection. These ones aren't that good. I don't really recommend them. They're just like kind of boring for me personally. But really cute, simple, fun summer look. I really enjoyed my time with that palette. I think the shimmers aren't the greatest because they aren't sticking to my lid the most. They're a little bit transparent, but the colors are so fun. So we'll see. I have to continue playing with that palette. But anyways, thank you for sticking around with my life update. I hope you found it somewhat interesting. I'm really, really excited to step into this new journey, this new career, and just hoping that things work out for me and Jose and that we can really start our lives together and all of that. So, and again, I cannot thank you guys enough for the continued support you have given me through all of the busyness and complaining that I've been doing. Like, I cannot put into words how thankful I am for you guys. So that's all I have for today's video. If you aren't subscribed to my channel already, I hope you would consider taking the time to do so. I have lots of new fun content coming, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye guys, have a good one.